Tonight, live from the Inspire Theater on the corner of Las Vegas Boulevard and Fremont Street in the heart of capital downtown Las Vegas, we present Vegas Talk, starring your hosts, Dylan Jorgensen, Andy Donahue, Bunny Gold, Jason Outlaw, music by yours truly, DJ Lenny Love Alfonso. Tonight's guest, Beasley Productions, Aaron James and Stephanie Loginus. Author of Faith and Fake News, Dr. Hugh Carter Donahue. From Volunteers in Medicine of Southern Nevada, Lisa Kern and Jenny Pakova. Music performance by Jennifer Outlaw. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for Dylan Jorgensen.
Okay,
so it's 3, 2, 1. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for the dynamic duo, Jason Outlaw and Jeremy Martin.
Here we go.
Hey, what's happening? What's happening? Woohoo!
Right. You want to kick it? Give it up for DJ Lenny Alfonso. Let's hear for him.
It's supposed to scratch.
It was a kick and a chop and
you
a
kick first.
Yeah, that's how you do it right there. That's good
stuff.
That's it. Well, ladies and gentlemen, this is what's in the news. Floyd Mayweather is opening a strip club. That's right. It's going to be called Bitches with Stitches. Thank you.
You get it.
Thank you. My mom thought that was awesome. Okay, cool. All right. Feel free. Go
ahead. Yeah. A local man punches a cougar in the head to save his dog, right? Caitlyn Jenner was just trying to get some love. Come on, why you gotta hit her in the head?
Did we get an aw? We got one aw? Someone said it's aw time already, guys. It's like aw. Hatchimals. Everyone heard of these Hatchimal things? They are having issues. Their users, what they have to do is they play and nurture the egg for up to an hour. That's right. They listen to it coo, and then the Hatchimal inside pecks its way through. Okay. However, according to some parents, the Hatchimals are never hatching. So the kids are just sitting there hanging out. They're not opening, so the only thing they could tell their kids is 2016 killed them. Yeah, 2016.
You guys may have heard about this. The inventor of the Red Solo Cup died today. Yeah. He was all alone when it happened.
I like that one. Woo! Everyone remember the hit show Alf?
Yeah.
Remember Alf? Yes. Yeah. Yes, the actor that played Alf died at 76 today. That's right.
Yeah, no. 2016's moved on to killing our aliens now. E.T. better watch out.
Yes, yes. Killing the aliens. All right. This is going over
joke.
Like a fart in a spacesuit. All right, good. Solid. You see, it's a fart. And it recently. Okay, you got it. Never mind. All right. There's a petition going around to make Princess Leia a Disney princess.
Yes. They actually reached out to Carrie Fisher, but she hasn't replied yet on her thoughts.
Did we get an O? Oh, my gosh. Yeah. But that is a very sweet thing. When she hears about it, her heart's just going to explode.
It's going to explode.
It's going to be awesome.
With joy. Isn't it? Yeah. They're going to have to give her C-3PR. That's
high five. That was for us.
We don't care if you liked it.
Sometimes
and her mom definitely won't be dancing in the rain.
That's good. You got one. George Lucas is like, damn it.
George Lucas in the audience.
All right. Yes, give it up for George Lucas, everybody. Yeah. George Lucas in the house. What? George Lucas. All right, cool. That's only because he has a gray beard. Okay, cool. All right. So there's a lot of New Year's resolutions are going around. It's that time of year. So right now we have some New Year's resolutions from celebrities. That's right. Donald Trump has a New Year's resolution. He's going to figure out what the hell he's doing. Hashtag no clue.
It's a big year for him to figure that out. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, 2016 has a New Year's resolution. It's going to kill another celebrity and do it in 2017. Hashtag, they'll never know it's me.
There you go.
Sneaky.
Hillary Clinton, her New Year's resolution is to find a new hobby. Hashtag, how did I lose?
Vladimir Putin is going to become more stealthy with Cobra attacks. Hashtag, shirtless cyber with Trump.
Cyber, yes. All right. Tony Romo, quarterback for the Dallas Cowboys, he says he's going to stay healthy next year and not get hurt. Hashtag pad my vagina. Vagina, is that the one that got you? That's the one.
Kanye West also has a New Year's resolution to become mentally stable. Hashtag, this bitch making me cray cray.
Yes. All right, ladies and gentlemen, hey, we got a wonderful show. Give it up for Jerry Morgan.
Hey, give it up for Jason Outlaw.
And give it up for DJ Lenny Alfonso.
Get the audio going.
Welcome back, Vegas Talk. Now, my next guests are filmmakers who are working on a very important film here at a local high school all about bullying. Let's find out what this is all about by meeting Stephanie Lajeunesse and Farron James.
Hi.
How are you? Have a seat, please.
Okay.
Hi, Stephanie.
Hello.
Hi. Get cozy, y'all.
Okay. Get cozy.
Yes. Now, you guys are working on a very important film about bullying called We the Freaks.
Yes.
Right? What inspired this for you, first of all?
I read this article about this high school student named Amanda Todd, and she did this online video with these cue cards telling her story about being bullied, and the same night she committed suicide.
That's horrible.
And I was bullied in elementary school, and I have a 11-year-old son who's been bullied, and it's just something that's really difficult to go through. Mm-hmm. And we decided to take a different approach with this film. Instead of showing the acts of bullying, it's the consequences and then the aftermath. Mm-hmm. And so that's where it starts, and kind of, you know, help people build the confidence within themselves so that no one could ever take that from them.
Right. And Farron, you produced and wrote the script, and you're directing,
yes,
correct?
I'm directing.
And you guys are casting right now, and you're casting at a local high school.
Yeah, well, we actually found a majority of our main characters. We're casting the rest at the high school, yeah.
And what high school are you guys casting at?
Spring Valley High.
That's great.
Yeah.
That's great. When do you plan on starting to film this?
We are hoping to film by early next year. Funding has been pushing us back a little bit, but we're still trucking on.
Right, yeah, and it's expensive to make a film. We'll talk a little bit more about the funding here in a little bit. But I also want to talk about, so when you talk about bullying, do you guys ever get into the topic of, like, why do kids bully, and is there a way to prevent that?
That's something that we talked about a lot during the early stages of developing this film. We got together and we were thinking, what are the reasons that people bully other people? And a lot of the times it comes to the bullies have something that they're dealing with personally,
right,
and they're projecting it onto someone else. And so that's why we are focusing on a theme of self-empowerment for this film. We know that bullying is going to happen. You know, it happens in elementary school, it happens in high school. You even move on to adulthood and it still happens, you know. And so we just want to take this idea of figuring out who you are as a person, finding your own self-worth and saying, you know, you're important. The things that you do are important in the world. You know, even though this person may not see that in you, there are other people that will see that in you. And most importantly, you need to see that in yourself.
Right.
Because if you can see that in yourself, then you can move on.
You don't have to bully or be bullied. With the seriousness of this film, a lot of actors, you know, take themselves very seriously. And you guys have cast a lot of people, had to do a lot of auditions. Do you have anybody that's just been a real diva or a real brat, that you've tried to cast and was just really, rude or anything?
So far, no, luckily.
So far we haven't had any.
But we did encounter the same actor who came out to audition, the guy who wrote on our Facebook and was like, this is a terrible film. Why would you want to go out for it? And it's because you didn't get a part in it, and you're just being me now.
He's trying to bully you.
Yeah,
he was. That's exactly what it was.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it was.
A little bit of cyberbullying. Do you guys have anybody who has, like, a really ridiculous writer? Like, I have to have, Evian water only, or fresh champagne.
These actors
hair and
are
makeup.
Not at that level.
Do you have any recommendations for somebody who does have a rider that's not being fulfilled?
Actually, now that I think about it, when I was in school, there were a couple students or a couple of classmates that they had some actors that did have some weird requests and, hey, can I even rewrite your script? And we straight up told her, we said, you need to tell your actress that they need to respect you as the director or you will find someone else.
Right.
Because there's more talent out there.
Yeah.
That will
cooperate. I mean, sometimes.
Cooperate.
Sometimes there's not. Dylan. I've had writer issues ever since I started this show. It's neither here nor now. Here nor there. So, well, it sounds like a very fun project nonetheless. I know it's a serious topic, but it sounds like you guys are having fun and bringing a lot of awareness to the local high schools. And it's going to be aired in the high school, right?
Yeah. So the vice principal that we're working with, he's super helpful. He wants to use it as an educational film. It's about 20 minutes long, so he wants to let the students view it and then have a discussion about it afterwards. And then he also has a lot of contacts across the nation that he can possibly give those out to. So huge possibilities in
it. Yeah, it could go nationwide or even worldwide. I'm sure this isn't just a problem in the U.S.
Right.
Right.
So you were talking about funding. It costs money to, you know, film and to produce these
Unfortunately.
Things.
Unfortunately.
How can people help you? How can people, you know, jump in and help? I know you're doing kind of like a GoFundMe type thing. How can people find you?
We actually just shot a promo video for our Indiegogo, and we're getting that straight. So we're going to launch our crowdfunding very soon, but you can go to our Facebook, like our page, and then we'll keep you updated with any way that you can help.
And what's your Facebook handle?
Facebook.com at We the Freaks.
We the Freaks. So go to Facebook.
Film. We the Freaks Film. Sorry.
We the Freaks Film.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Awesome. So go to We the Freaks Film, donate, and help this project come to fruition so that high schoolers all over Las Vegas, the United States, and possibly the world can, you know, get aware and of themselves, become aware of their bullying and how it affects other people and what to do when you're being bullied as well.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Thank you guys for coming
Thank
on.
Thank you for
Can't
having
Can't wait
us.
To watch your film when it's done. Woo! All
right. Thank you and welcome back. All right, our next guest, we're very thrilled to have. His latest book is titled Faith and Fake News, an exploration at the past 2 years of our cherished lives. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Hugh Carter Donahue. Welcome.
Oh, wonderful.
Thank you for joining us, Dr. Donahue.
Great to be here. I love Vegas talk.
So, faith and fake news.
Yes, that's it.
Where do those two things come together?
Well, they came together with Mrs. Clinton because, like any number, there's a lot of women in the New Testament in particular mm-hmm. who have faith that they embody and they go to places that they're not welcome.
Oh.
And there are several. And there's a particular one in Luke. And she fits that because she's always challenging things in her career mm-hmm. by taking on challenges and taking on causes where people aren't willing to do it.
Wow. Like a Democrat campaigning in Elko, Nevada, for example.
I don't know. I didn't know Elko, Nevada.
Well, I don't know if they do either, so I'll take that as a yes.
Yeah.
Now, the fake news side of it.
Now, the fake news side of it comes about because on September 11th in 2012, there was a tragedy that befell the country with an attack on a State Department villa and a CIA outpost in Benghazi, Libya, felling the ambassador and three men. And there was a very thorough investigation of it through a number of House and Senate hearings. In 2013 and 2014, but even though there was nothing really new that they knew of, they pursued with yet another one.
Another hearing.
Another hearing called the Select Committee.
Oh, the Select Committee.
Yeah, the Select Committee on Benghazi. Mm-hmm. And the Select Committee tried to insinuate that Mrs. Clinton ordered the troops of the United States not to help the men, which was a complete fabrication. And it produced this constant reiteration of news that wasn't really news.
Reiteration by where?
By everywhere. I mean, they'd just take something that had been addressed in either an earlier House or an earlier Senate hearing and say it over and over again, and it was always just repetition and repetition. So it became fake.
Hmm. So are you putting it to us that our peer outlets were not very selective in reporting on a select committee?
I would say that's the most generous way to characterize the profession. Quite honestly, yes.
Oh, well, we outdid him on a campaign coverage, but it seems like saying nothing was a little better than saying something fake, like fake news. And this is something that Lenny and I personally just pore over. And
yes, I would think, because I know Lenny's always on the ball.
Always.
I was here earlier in the year, and I came to admire Lenny a great deal.
He's only gotten better. As he continues to...
I would say that Lenny's timeless.
Timeless?
Timeless. I would say that Lenny's timeless.
Yeah. Lenny's timeless.
Yeah. And if I can be a little bold, I will say, Lenny, I am the only person who will liken you to Marlene Dietrich. Because that's what Hemingway said about Marlene Dietrich.
That's deep. Wow.
It's okay, Lenny.
Wow. All right, well, we're glad you're here, because while Lenny and I are often highly conscientious,
yes,
we've hit a stumbling block, an obstacle. We've come across a few items, and we can't tell whether it's news or a cruise. Lenny, are you ready?
It's time to play. Is it cruising? Yeah, we got you.
Thank you for joining us, Lenny.
Thank you for having me.
It's exciting to be here with you at this time.
Couldn't get a guest today.
Well, it's something we care about. For those of you who don't know, we're about to play News or Cruise. A quick example is a seafaring voyage that's fun for the whole family is a cruise. Senator Bernie Sanders winning a primary, your caucus, is news. Are you ready to play?
I am ready.
Our expert celebrity judge, Dr. Donahue, are you ready to play?
Absolutely, sure.
We're all ready. All right, now we did the example. You were briefed on the rules beforehand. Yeah. Here we go. Number one, one of America's top guns finds an affinity for beach volleyball. Is it cruise or news, Lenny?
That would be cruise.
It would be a cruise.
Yeah.
Dr. Donahue?
Yeah. Tom Cruise.
It's a cruise, the Tom Cruise, of course. Fascinating. Good call. Did you already know that, or did you use deductive reasoning?
Top Gun Cruise, yeah.
Volleyball. It just came right together. just great. Now, our next example that we're having a lot of trouble with here, Professor, is a GOP lawmaker offered to pay Hillary Clinton's legal fees. What do you think?
Without theme music. So. Mm. That would be news.
It would be news? Is it news?
Trey Gowdy. It's news.
What? Trey Gowdy, what happened?
He wanted to keep her talking.
So he offered to pay her legal expenses to have all the high-priced lawyers there to make sure she answered correctly. Is that why it happened?
I think his hope was that she'd answer.
Just looking for an answer.
Yeah.
We're with you, Trey. Yeah. We're all looking for answers.
Yeah.
All right.
At that point in time, she had worn him down well enough that an answer, just an answer. Yeah. I don't think veracity was high on the expectation.
Veracity not high. Legal fees very high. Taking us round three.
Yeah.
Lenny, we have a Texas Solicitor General cites the Simpsons as precedent while making the case of his lifetime. Is that cruise or news? Smells like cruise. Dr. Donahue.
The senator himself.
Of course, Ted Cruz was often quoting The Simpsons on the campaign trail. That was a thinker. Thank goodness we're surrounded by two smart gentlemen. All right. And Lenny's gotten them all right, hasn't he?
Dietrich, you know.
Dietrich.
You know.
All right. Well, this is the final one that we're having trouble with. So hopefully we're going to break on through to the other side. Here we go. Federal American law enforcement agencies refer to Russian intelligence agencies as codename Cozy Bear and Fancy Bear. What do you think, Lenny?
I think that would be news.
Is it news? You gotta be kidding me. Is that news?
Cozy Bear and Fancy Bear are the nicknames the FBI and Homeland Security gave to the Russian spy services in an official document at 1 p.m. this afternoon.
That's not only news, it's breaking news. Oh, my gosh. How did you know? Well, with Lenny's rapid speed, he's not going on cruise control. He's making news. Thank you for playing, Lenny. We're glad to have you.
Thanks for having me.
All right, and Dr. Donahue, thank you for joining us. His current title is Faith and Fake News. It's available on Amazon. Go check it out. Thank you.
Love it, the volunteers. Well, this is our volunteer appreciation episode, so it's very fitting that we have, from the Volunteers in Medicine of Southern Nevada, their volunteer director and an actual volunteer. So please put your hands together for Lisa Curran and Jenny Petkova. Come on out. Welcome.
Hi.
Oh, no awkward hugs, sorry. Just kidding. Oh, thank you. I love awkward hugs. Thanks.
Hello.
It's a pleasure to have you guys. She said our rehearsal hug was awkward, so you guys are in on it.
No.
So you are obsessed with fingernails, and
I
you
strangely are. Don't look at them now.
No, you said okay. So in reality, you said that one of your favorite things to do is go on Pinterest and look up fingernail designs.
Like nail designs, yeah.
Could you just explain that whole thing?
You know, when I'm feeling a little bit low or just sad, the nails and sparkle glitter makes me feel happy. I like pretty things. What? There's nothing wrong with
it. No, there's nothing wrong with it. That's the best thing I ever heard. Give it up for fingernails. I was going to say, yeah, passion. Fingernail passion. All right, but you're here to talk about volunteers, which is what our episode is all about. So, at the Volunteers in Medicine of Southern Nevada, you are coordinating them. Why would somebody want to volunteer at an organization like yours?
Sure. We've got a lot of different volunteer opportunities within our clinic. So someone like Jenny, who's actually a UNLV student, is able to grow within our program and learn many different things and get some exposure to the medical facility. And then we've got the medical professionals who like to give back to our community and just feel good about what they're doing.
Okay. So the benefit is in the experience and the skills that they're getting,
exactly.
Right.
Okay,
so Jenny, I was wondering, could you walk us through what your experience has been like? Like, I know, you know, how long have you been volunteering? Where did you start? Kind of walk me through the things that you learned and how it's been.
Yeah, so I actually started about a year and a half ago as front desk, as most people start. And then I graduated on to back desk, where I did all the scanning and stuff like that to scan in the patient charts and everything. And then now I'm actually the highest position, the most advanced one that has the most responsibility, and that's the medical scribe, which actually gets to go into the rooms with the doctor and kind of note everything that they say, which is, you know, important so we keep track of what they do. And I also do a lot of the trainings too for scribing.
Yeah, can you verify that's all true?
Yes, it is.
Oh, congratulations. It's amazing. Good
I love
job
Lisa
on all
too.
That. Yeah, that's a lot of scribing.
So
we talked about a seriousness level that you have for your volunteers.
Sure.
Could you explain what kind of expectations you have for them?
Sure. So our clinic runs on the work of our volunteers. So about 85% of the work that's completed is done through volunteer work. So naturally, we have very high expectations for all of our volunteers. And we treat our volunteer positions just like a paying job. So anyone who wants to volunteer with us will go through an interview process. We'll make sure that they meet our qualifications and what we're looking for in our volunteers. And then they get trained in the position that they're interested in volunteering with us. So very high expectations.
Yeah. See, that's one of the things I really respect about the whole organization is it's not easy to get people to volunteer time and treat it like a paid job. So I think setting those expectations is something you guys have really done a great job of.
Yeah.
So yeah, let's give them up for that. It's pretty impressive what you do, yeah.
It's all her. The first thing that she said to me, one of the first times I met her, she actually goes, you know, if you ever feel bored, if you ever feel like you have nothing to do, just go and introduce yourself to the staff members and ask them if they need any help with anything, and they'll always give you a project. They've always done such a good job. Like, the whole staff creates an environment where, you know, you like being there. I love it there, honestly. And they just make you feel included in everything, and, like, you're making a difference in someone's life rather than just, you know, doing mindless work.
Yeah, and when you went up to somebody and, like, you know, introduced yourself, did you ever feel like you were taking away from their time to, you know, volunteer with someone else, or how did you balance that?
I feel like everyone there is so nice, and if you go up to them, they're more than happy to give you something that you can help them with, and they're more than happy to share their skills with you. Development, yeah, she gives me a lot of projects too that she needs done with the VMSN ball that we have and stuff, and she's always more than happy to have us there.
Oh yeah, that was a great event, by the way. Yeah, we were, me and Alan and a few other podcast people were there, so that was a great event. Mm-hmm. We know she's doing good at fundraising, but we'll talk about that.
Yeah.
Okay. What volunteer opportunities are there right now for somebody to get involved?
So we've obviously got some medical professional volunteer opportunities. So if a doctor wants to volunteer with us or a nurse, that's obviously how we provide our free medical care to low-income, uninsured Nevada residents. But we also have non-medical volunteer positions that help us staff the front desk and the back desk.
Okay, that's good to know.
Yeah, or exactly.
Like, so the average person who wants to help does have some
Everyone
ways they can
come
get
and volunteer. It's a wonderful place.
All right. Holiday season, it's a good time to get the ask out while you can, you know.
Exactly.
They're in the right mood. I can see why these college kids are volunteering. I can see why regular folk like me would volunteer. But I don't know why a doctor would. Because a doctor puts in so much time into their education to get paid a massive amount of money for very specific hard work. How are you getting them to donate all the hours? Because they're sort of the core of this project.
Sure. A lot of our doctors enjoy spending a lot of time with our patients, so they're not as rushed as they might be in their private practice or working in a hospital, for example. They have some time to connect with our patient population and our community as a whole. So that's one thing that they enjoy that they get from their volunteer experience with us. Also, they can focus on just medical care because we've got VMSN staff and volunteers who take care of the back end kind of tasks. They just come in, volunteer as a doctor, just focus on patient care, and that's what they get to focus on.
Man.
So
that's such an impressive thing that you guys have done. Give it up for them. I think that's really really impressive. Okay, so let's hear some firsthand stories. Now, you've been volunteering. Could you walk me through whatever stands out in your mind as the epitome of what the experience is like? So somebody can kind of imagine being in your shoes.
Yes. I actually have a story that kind of touched my heart that happened a little while ago. So I'm not trying to give too many details, you know, of the patient, but this patient had come in.
Yeah, give
and
him up. Yeah.
It's a violation. She knows better.
And,
good girl.
We are a medical facility, so, I mean, sometimes we have to deliver not so good news.
Oh.
And what had happened is this a patient had to get a medical procedure done that was very, very costly and had to take time away from her work. And the first thing the patient said to us, kind of as a team, you know, the doctor was in there was a nurse and myself scribing, and she said, you know, I can't do that. I can't do this procedure, even though it was her life pretty much depended on this procedure. She said, I can't take 2 months off of work. I am the only provider in my household, and if I stop working, then my kids will go hungry. I have no way of providing for them. And it just kind of puts stuff into perspective for me that, you know, people are faced with these decisions every day. And it's kind of, it's sad because, you know, that's your health. And the fact that you have to sacrifice your health so that you can provide for your family is just crazy to me. And that's why I appreciate everything that VMSN does, because they provide free health care to those in need. And what the doctor actually did is she, you know, gathered her sponsors, her doctor friends, her colleagues, and she actually got her, like, a really expensive procedure done for absolutely no cost to the patient.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's so cool. Yeah. It feels so good having you guys as one of our sponsors. You know, from a couple episodes ago, we had you guys come in and talk about the dental clinic, and there was a story that was told that keeps getting told back to me about a man who didn't have the ability to chew, and like he couldn't, you know, do anything with his teeth, and they mm-hmm. fixed it up so much to the point that he was able to go on a date. And it was like, it was such a humanizing story. I could totally imagine being in a situation like that and how good that must feel. So I'm glad these kind of things are spreading. Now, before I let you go, I want to talk about this $50,000. For the last few episodes, we've been saying, you know, to the audience at home and here to match donations. You know, today's the progress update.
Yes, so we had a grant come in that agreed to match $50,000. So basically whatever you donated was valued at twice its value. So if you donated a dollar, it was worth $2 and et cetera because we had this grant. But we reached our goal, $50,000. So it was actually $100,000.
Yes.
Yay, thank you.
We did it. We did it together, everyone.
Yes, but our clinic is funded through private donations and mostly grants. We don't get any federal funding, so there are still ways to donate.
Okay.
You can text VMSN to 91999. Just text right away, and it's that easy. I've done it myself.
I can just text away money?
It's pretty rad.
I text it, and then it comes out of my wallet?
I don't really know exactly what
happens. Okay,
anyway, sorry. or you can go to our website, vmsn.org, and donate on the website as well.
All right, so text your money to them.
Yeah.
Yeah, get that going. And thank you so much for coming out and chatting with us, Lisa and Jenny.
Thank you.
Really appreciate it.
Awesome.
Okay, so and everyone who's at home, stay tuned, because after this break, we have a special treat for you. An amazing local singer, Jennifer Outlaw, will be performing live on this stage. Ooh. Stay tuned.
All right.
You did a great job. Nice. Back
yeah.
Back to your
Nailed
heavy,
it.
Back to your heavy drinking.
Yeah. Heavy drinking. I have two beers.
No, it's a good. It's a good. You haven't beer.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jennifer Outlaw.
Tell me where I'm broken.
ladies and gentlemen, Jennifer Outlaw. Ladies and gentlemen, that's our show. I'd like to thank all of our guests this evening. Thank you to our cast and crew. And to all you Vegas talkers at home. Remember, you're all welcome to be a part of our last episode, January 5th, right here at the Inspire